Good morning and namaste. How are you today? Good? Yes. As you know, we have been studying in detail the Natya Shastra because it is one of the most and perhaps the most treatise on Indian performing arts. Bharata has devoted 7 chapters to music in his what we call magnum opus, the Natya Shastra. He explains the 3 major aspects of music, that is swara, the note, atodya, instruments, and gana, the song, gana. Swara is the base for both instrumental and vocal music. The vocal and instrumental music enhances the histrionic expressions in drama and adds charm and value to the production. The term Gandharva is comprehensive term in the text that incorporates the study of the note, instrument, tala, that is the time measure, and the song. Based on this, the music field is divided into 3 categories as Swaratmaka Gandharva, pertaining to the notes and pure music; Talatmaka Gandharva, pertaining to the tala, that is the time measure, and the instrumental music; and Padatmaka Gandharva, that is the composition of the song and vocal music. Swaratmaka Gandharva, the pure music. What it is? It is to be explained in detail. Swara is the note produced from the human throat and veena, the string instrument. There are 12 aspects of pure music. 1, the swara or the notes. 2, shruti or quarter notes. Murchana or scales. Grama or group. Tana or patterns of notes. Sthana, the origin of notes. Sadharana or intermediaries. Varna or combination of notes. Alankara or permutations of varnas. Jati or melodies. Dhatu or techniques of production of notes. Vritti or method of employing the technique. Except vrittis and dhatus, all the above aspects are common to both vocal and stringed instruments. Swara. There are 7 swaras. They are Shadaja, Rishab, Gandhara, Madhyama, Panchama, Daivat, and Nishad. While singing, it is sung as Sa, Ri, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni respectively, which correspond to C, D, E, F, G, A, and B in the diatonic scale of the Western music. The combination of these 7 notes with the quarter notes and tones result in the process. They are Vadi, life note in rag or the melody; Samvadi, the concordant note with the life note; Vivadi, the discordant note to the Vadi; Anuvadi, the note that is subordinate to the Vadi. Shruti. Shruti or the quarter tones are 22 in number. As the scales vary, the shruti in each swara also vary. Suppose the Shadaja Grama or the first group of scales, the shruti is Rishabha, are 3-2 in Gandhara, 4 in Madhyama, 4 in Panchama, 3 in Daivata, 2 in Nishada, and 4 in Shadaja. This will vary in the Madhyama Grama. Murchana. There are 14 Murchanas or scales of music. Each Grama or group has 7 scales. The seven scales in the Shadaja grammar starts with the notes sa, ni, da, pa, ma, ga, ri respectively. Similarly, in the Madhyama grammar scale, it starts with the first note ma, ga, ri, sa, ni, da, pa respectively. All these 14 scales are divided into four classes as Purna or heptatonic, Shadavita or hexatonic, Audavita or pentatonic, and Shadaranakrita or constituted with intermediaries. Now let's see further. Grammar. What is a grammar? These are two groups of scales known as Shadaja grammar and Madhya grammar. Tana. The variations in the scales of music depending on hexatones and pentatones are called tana or the patterns of notes. The tana helps to develop the murchanas. There are 28 tanas in the Shadaja grama murchana and 21 tanas in the Madhyama grama murchana in the hexatonic scales and 21 tanas in Shadaja grama murchana and 14 in the Madhya grama murchanas in the pentatonic scales, totaling to 84 in number. In strings instruments, there are two more variations of tana which depend on the stress and intonation imposed on the swaras. What is sthanas? The sthanas are the points from where the notes originate. The chest, throat and head are the points from where the notes emanates. Shadaranas. They are the intermediary notes. There are two types of intermediary notes known as Swara Shadarana and Jati Shadarana. In the first one, the intermediary note lies between two specified notes. In Jati Shadarana, the raga rendered is intermediary between two specific raga. Varna. Varna means production of swaras in particular order or pitch. They are the combination of notes. There are four classes of varnas. They are arohanam or the ascending notes, avarohanam or the descending notes, sthayi the static note and sanchari the transitory note. Alankar. The alankar depends on the varna. Without alankar, the song becomes a mere chanting. According to Bharata, there are 34 alankars. Jatis or melodies. Jatis are 18 in number and they correspond to the modern ragas. Those depend on the Shadaja grama are 7 and Madhyama grama are 11. Beside this, each melody has two variations called Shuddha and Vikrita. Jati have 10 characteristic features. Bharata has also mentioned the appropriate raga to be employed for a particular rasa. Dhatu. They are the techniques of production of notes. In Veena, the dhatu has four variations. Depending on the variations of the dhatu, four classes of melodies are obtained. They are Uddhata, Lalita, Rabita and Ghana. Vrittis. As you can now see in all these, so much of the terminology of Natya Shastra is repeated, but in different contexts. So the vrittis are the methods of employing the musical techniques. This mainly pertains to instrumental music. The nature of vritti is determined by the type of instrument, tala, laya, gati, yati and marga that is used. There are three types of vrittis called chitra, vartika and dakshina. Tala. Tala is a time measure based on the basic unit of time or kal. Scholars opine that kal can vary from a split second to a few seconds in the Indian music. There are two standard talas known as Chatushra and Tishra. There is also Mishra Tala which includes qualities of the other two. Chachaputta Tala. Chachaputta Tala and Shakti Putraka Tala belong respectively to the categories of Chatusha, Tishra and Mishra Talas. Apart from these, there are two more Talas derived from Tishra Tala. They are Samparki, Shataka and Udghata. They are yet other derived time measures governed by 5, 7, 9, 10 or 11 kalas. The execution of tala, if produced sound, is called Sashabda Kriya, and if does not produce sound, it is known as Nishabda Kriya. Lai is made in accordance with the time of the kala into which matras have been divided. Lai is of three kinds, that is Druta, the fast, Madhyama, the medium, and Vilambita, slow. It is the Madhyama Laya which determines the Pramana Kala, that is what is we call normal speed. Song is a literally composition with the meaning Swara and Tala, and it is called a Pada or song. Song is also called Dhruva if it consists of decorative verses, Varnas, Alankars, Laya, Jati and Banis. Bharata has devoted an entire chapter for Dhruva songs and Dhruva Gana. While composing a Dhruva, the following aspects are to be incorporated: the nature of the theme, play and character, the rasa and bhava, time, place, occasion, age and state of the mind of the character. The content of Dhruva is very special and cannot be inserted in the regular dialogue of the play. Dhruvas are derived from various meters and primarily they are 64 in number. Each Dhruva are further classified. There are five situations in which Dhruva Gana is employed in a play. They are during the entry of the characters or the Pravesha. It is called Praveshika Dhruva. At the time of exit or Nishkarma, it is called Nishkarma Dhruva. At intervals during pure dance or Akshepa, the song is called Akshepiki Dhruva. During the change of Rasa or Prasadhana, it is called Prasiddhika Dhruva. Characters subject to high emotions or antara, it is called antara dhruva. Bharata has explained the prosody, meters and its divisions, the unison of rasas and bhavas, the similes to be incorporated, the content, language, talas and the usage of the dhruva in various types of dhruva gana. Bharata has also defined the various songs to be sung in rituals before the actual play begins. Let's talk about the musical instruments. Bharata narrates the origin of various instruments through a story. A sage named Swati went to a lake on a rainy day to fetch water from the nearby lake. It was very windy and the sprinkles of the rain on the lotus leaves made the birds very happy and they made inexplicable sweet sounds. The fall of the water made a melodious sound and the birds produced sounds in different notes and pitches. This made the sage ponder over the possibility of making musical instruments and incorporate these sounds. He consulted Vishwakarma, the celestial architect, and made different drums, mrudanga, panava, and dardura. He covered these instruments with animal membranes and tensioned them with strings. He also constructed jallari, pataha, muraja, alingya, and Ankika in the format of Durdubhi, the celestial drum. The highly creative sage Swati further created many instruments in wood and iron and covered them with animal membrane. There are major and minor instruments. Among the string instruments made in wood Vipanchi and Sitra, Chitra types of Veenas are major instruments, and Kachapi, Goshtaka, etc. are the minor instruments. Among the percussion instruments, Mridanga, Panava, Dardura are classified under major instruments, whereas Jallari, Pataha, etc. fall under minor instruments. All these instruments are used in Dasharupaka plays. Depending on the rasa and bhava portrayed, some instruments gain importance and the rest of them have an important role in the plays. Regular musical instruments are of four types. They are string, covered, solid and hollow instruments. But before we go into that details, do you realize and see here the oneness of nature that has inspired an human being to create this classical music, the music? Because as you see, it is the sound of the rains. The sound of the rains falling on lotus leaves and petals. I mean, just see the harmony and beauty that is created and the performing arts that bring out this beauty. Stringed instruments or tat atodya. Strings are those with strings like veena, covered means the drums. Solid is the cymbal and hollow instrument like the flute. There are three types of techniques while playing the veena. There are tattva, anugata and ogha. In tattva, the instrument is played mainly to denote the rhythm, taal, etc. of a particular song. Tattva is to be applied in vilambit, laya, slow tempo. In anugata, the instrument is played to follow the tempo of the song. Anugata is always played in madhya laya. The instrument, when played to embellish the song with no particular significance attached to it, is the ogha. The first music in Drutalaya, where Abhida Karanas are predominant, is called the Ogha. The Swaras have two bases, that is the human throat and the Veena. The aspects of the music of Veena are Swara, Gramas, Murchanas, Thana, Sthana, Vritti and Sadharana. Varna, Alankars, Dhatu, Shruti and Jatis are constituted by Vidhiswaras and are produced in the wooden veena. The karanas in playing the vipanchi are rupa, krip prati tatra, pratibeda, rupasesha, ogha and pratishushka. When on veena, if too heavy and too light syllables are played, it is rupa. This rupa performed in the pratibeda is krita prati krita. When two different karanas are side by side played on veena and heavy and light syllables are exhibited, it is pratibheda. Continuing the music in another veena when the principal veena has been stopped is rupashesha. The ogha includes the abhidha karanas performed in the Upari Pani Grama Marga. The Pratisuka is the Karana which is played by means of one string. The Chitra is a Veena with seven strings which is played with the fingers, and Vipanchi is that with nine strings which is played with the plectrum. Among the wooden string instruments, Vipanchi and Chitra are major instruments and Kapachi and Goshaka are minor instruments. The orchestra of the string instruments consists of the singers and his attendants, the players of the vipanchi, veena and flute. Players of mridanga, panava and dardura are classified under the orchestra of covered instruments. The string instruments, which consist of swara, tala and pada and depends on various other instruments, are known as gandharva. The source of gandharva is human throat, the veena and the flute. Wind instruments or shushir atodya. The hollow musical wind instrument is a flute made of bamboo. It is called vamshi, which means made of bamboo. The notes in this instrument are produced by opening or closing of the holes by the fingers simultaneously while blowing. The rules regarding the notes of the flute are known to have 2, 3, and 4 shrutis and are either shaken, half open, and fully open. Just like the way a note of veena is changed into another while playing the flute, it is the same as veena. The notes of the flute should be perfected with the help of veena and human throat. A unison of human throat, veena, and flute produces a very special effect. The music of the flute, which is steady or not very loud and furnished with varnas and alankaras, are very sweet and soothing to the listener. Among the hollow instruments, the flute is major instrument and conch shell and dakini are minor instruments. Percussion instruments or avanada atodya. There are number of percussion instruments. They are usually hollow in the body and open either on one side or both and covered with animal membranes that has uniform thickness. Among the drums, mridangam, dardura and pavana are the major instruments, while jhalira and pataha are the minor instruments. The body of the mridangam is hollow and is made of particular seasoned wood. Either side of the mridangam is covered and closed with membranes. The right side of membrane head is permanently loaded. The left side of the membrane is loaded with wheat flour to ensure the correct consonance with the main note. Mridanga is a very popular Indian instrument used in music and dance concerts. When mridanga follows a performance, it is anuvadya. When mridanga is played simultaneously with performance, is samavadita. Panavas are regional instruments. It is made of wood. The experts in playing panava should produce sound by striking loosely and tightly. Play the different karana by means of the tip of the little and ring fingers. In producing the remaining sounds, there should be strokes of other fingers. Darduras appear like a huge gong made of bell metal. While playing the dardura, the sound will be wrongly produced if they are swiftly done or done in quick succession. In playing the three instruments together, some karanas are distinctly expressed, while some karanas are produced simultaneously or some serially. Generally, panava should be taken up for play before all other instruments. The metal instruments or ghana atodya. The cymbal is a metal instrument also called a talam. This is used to keep the rhythm or taal. In an orchestra, it is used to keep the rhythm intact. In dance recital, it complements the kanukol and keeps the time measure. There is no instrument which cannot be used in the 10 kinds of play. Each kind of instrument is used in play, considering the sentiment and the mood of the character. In a festival, a royal procession, a mangala ceremony, in an auspicious and an happy occasion, at times of marriage and birth of sons, in a battle where many fighters assemble, all musical instruments should be played. Few instruments are to be played during ordinary household functions. During extraordinary marches and performance of the play, all instruments should be played. All instruments covered with hide are called pushkaras. There are 100 varieties of covered instruments. The pushkaras have no harshness of sound like the remaining instruments. By playing of bheri, pataha, bhamba, dundubhi and dundims, the depth of sound should be produced from their slackness and extensive surface. These are generally to be played with a view to time and occasion. Mridanga is a very popular Indian instrument used in music and dance concert. When mridanga follows a performance, it is anuvadya. When mridanga is played simultaneously with the performance, it is samavadita. Panava are regional instruments. It is made of wood. The experts in playing Panava should produce sound by striking loosely and tightly. Play the different karanas by means of the tip of the little and ring fingers. In producing the remaining sounds, there should be strokes of other fingers. Durduras appear like huge gong made of bell metal. While playing the durdura, the sound will be wrongly produced if they are swiftly done or done in quick succession. In playing the three instruments together, some karnas are distinctly expressed, while some karnas are produced simultaneously or some serially. Generally, Panava should be played before all other instruments. The notes produced by the singer should be produced by the musical instruments, and this should contain light and heavy syllables showing appropriate yati and pani. There are five kinds of hand strokes, which are level-handed, half-handed, quarter-face, hand-side and forefinger. These hand strokes, according to their application, are controlled, semi-controlled or free. The four margas relating to the strokes of covered instruments are Adita, Alipta, Vitata and Gomukha. One who knows how to give proper plastering to drums and has undergone extensive training in the four margas and knows songs in summer and knows many kinds of good music is a perfect mrudangam player. One who is unerring, expert in use of hands on drums and observing time and covering faults of the performance and well practiced in speaking karanas, playing karanas, is an expert player of pavana. The dardara player should be firm, clever in his art, swift, nimble and adept in playing other instruments. The playing of mridanga should have distinct strokes, clear, well divided, loud, at the same time controlled. It should include the three marjanas and should have the combination of pleasing notes to produce a good quality of music. The orchestra, as for Bharata, should be seated on the stage with their face to the east. While playing the drums, the experts in mridanga should produce the sounds in their instruments by the touch of their fingers. The music should be consisting of light varnas and relate to the tandava at the time of the appearance of dancer on the stage. Following this, the sannipata should be taken up. A music relating to the karana, conforming to the angahara of the lasya dance, should be combined with karana dhatu. From the time the curtains are raised, there should be the playing of drums for the success of the performance. The chitra, dakshina and vritti are the three types of procedure that enhance the good quality of the instrument music and vocal music. There are three types of playing veena. They are tattva, anugata and oga. The music where laya, tala, varda, pada, yati and akshara are expressed suitably is called tattva. Tattva is to be applied in vilambita laya. In anugata, the instrument is played to follow the tempo of the song. Anugata is always played in madhyalaya. The instrument is played to embellish the song with no particular significance is called oga. It is played in dhruta, that is fast tempo. In a regular play, bahir geetas are included in the preliminary performance. All these can be applied with or without tal, but always in styles of vritti and chitra. Bharata explains the application of jatis in Natya to express the rasa as its principal purpose. The melody acts on the listener to experience and image the situation described in the songs. Bharata mentions the qualities and defects of mukul music. He mentions that a defective voice cannot be used in singing. The male singer should be youthful, have pleasant voice and well versed in tala and laya. The female singer should have good appearance, melodious voice, brilliant, calm and adept to singing in consonance with the orchestra. A veena player must be untiring and accepting in playing chitraveena. A flute player must also be physically strong, steady and with breath control. So we can conclude that Bharata explains only some of the main aspects of music which was prevalent during his time and pertaining only to Natya. There were various aspects in the development of music which are not available today, and most of them have become obsolete during the efflux of time. For example, during Bharata's period, the melody was known as jati and at present it is called raga. The sarjagram and madhyamagrama have lost its significance to the present day music, and the melakarta scheme has replaced the grama system in the Carnatic music. As you will study the chapters concerning music or musical instruments and everything are 4 chapters from I think 19, 20, 21, 22 of the Natya Shastra, and it should be interesting to all students of dance to go through them and compare, as we are saying, what is there and what is changed and how it is modified. So this we conclude the class of the music is explained in the raga, the tala, the music in Natya Shastra. Thank you.